Please like, share and subscribe. Press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone. You are all welcome to lecture number 503. Today I am going to discuss about saponins and sapogenin. These saponins and sapogenins, they are organic compounds and they are from plant origin. They are found in fruit, seed, flower, in any part of the plant, and they are complex compound and they can be isolated from plant material by extraction either by ethyl alcohol or by water. And these complex compounds are precipitated out in presence of ether or acetone, and then they can be separated out. And these saponins, they have very specific taste. They give froth or leather in water, or I can say it is colloidal solution. And if you shake in water any drug which is rich in saponin, there will be formation of leather and it will stay for more than 30 minutes. That indicates that that particular plant material contains saponin. And if I say saponin, means it is glycosides. And if I mention sapogenin, it means it is non-glycoside, means sugar is not linked. These saponins are known as fish poison. They are bitter in taste and they are toxic for human beings. And why they are fish poison? Because they are capable of haemolyzing the two-chambered heart animals, and fish is two-chambered. So it is a poison to fish. And these saponins are used since more than 400-500 before, since long the villagers and people are using as a fish poison. Even today, in some of the remote area of bush area of Nigeria or even in villages in India, they will just identify, especially the Acacia arabica or Acacia series of plants, they are rich in saponin, especially their seeds. So what they will do, they will powder the seed and mix in water, since glycoside is soluble in water, and they will put in pond. And in the morning, they will see that all the fishes are floating, some are half dead, some are dead. And they are used as a, for fishing purpose, as a fish poison. And these saponins, they have two nucleus. One is called steroidal saponins, and second one is called terpenoidal saponins. When I say steroidal saponin, means those saponins which are having cyclopentanephrenthine nucleus. And once I say terpenoidal saponins, it means that those saponins are having isoprene unit in the form of terpene. Or in other words, we can say that all the steroidal saponins, they are four-member ring saponins, and those terpenoidal saponins, they are five-member rings. For example, if I say steroidal saponin, means it is having cyclopentanephrenthrene nucleus, means it will be having this nucleus. Cyclopentanol, this is phenanthrene nucleus. And this is a carbon skeleton. And here, this one we call steroidal. And if I say, here it is isoprene unit. This is terpene. So it will join in the form of long chain, and you will get this type of nucleus So it is having five ring, and this is having four rings. So these five member rings, they are terpenoidal, and the four member they are steroidal. So as I have told you that saponins, they are glycosides, and sapogenin, what I have written here, they are non-glycoside. So saponins, they are widely distributed in higher plants. Mostly they are found in higher plants, and they are characterized by the forming a colloidal solution in water, which gives on shaking froth and leather, and that froth which is formed or leather, if it stays for more than half an hour, it confirms that that particular extract of plant material is rich in saponin. They have bitter taste, and the drugs containing them are usually irritating to mucous membrane. They can haemolyse the red blood corpuscles. Actually, the haemolysis of red blood takes place of cold-blooded animal. Cold-blooded animal are those animals which are having two heart chamber like fish. So it is a deadly poison for fish. Of course, it is toxic to human beings because we have four chamber heart and we are warm-blooded. So all these saponins, they are known as fish poison because they can haemolyse the RBC, red blood cell. Haemolysis means our blood is having certain viscosity. So either if any substance, either it precipitates or it dilutes, that is haemolysis. Both condition is called poison, and that's why two type of poisoning is there, even by snake or by anything. Either one poison can precipitate the blood, where the your heart will stop, heart cannot work at precipitated blood. And second one is haemolysis, means where the viscosity is reduced. So these saponins, they are that type of poison where your red blood cell, your means the fish's red blood cell is haemolyzed. And that's why one poison is antidote for other, because if suppose somebody is suffering from that poison which is haemolyzing blood, so if you can give the antidote, that one which is precipitating blood, it can solve the problem, and that man can be recovered from poisoning. And the snakes, for example, are having two type of poison. One can haemolyze the blood, and other one can precipitate the blood. So here, the carcasses are poisonous to two chamber herd animals, like fish, or they are poison to cold-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animal means fish. Saponins are widely used as fish poison. Saponins have high molecular weight, and their isolation in pure state is difficult. They are usually extracted from plant material by hot ethyl alcohol or by water. And after the extraction, you evaporate the solvent, and it will be in the form of concentrate. And that concentrate can be precipitated out by treating with either ether or acetone. This extracted from the plant material and by hot ethyl alcohol or by hot water. And after concentration of the extract, they are precipitated out by ether or acetone. They form molecular compounds with certain steroids. And the saponins have been classified into two groups. One is steroidal saponins, and the other one is known as terpenoidal saponin. Now, I have already told you about the saponin. Now, sapogenin. Sapogenin means once glycoside is hydrolyzed in presence of acid or enzyme. So what a glycone is remaining, whether it is terpenoidal nucleus or it is steroidal nucleus, is called sapogenin. And here, let me make it very clear. Most of the students, even at PG level, right, master's level, even if they are doing MSc or M Pharma, they commit mistake. They write saponin glycoside. Once you are writing saponin, it is self-explanatory that it means you are talking of glycoside. Saponin word goes for glycoside. Once it is hydrolyzed, then it is called sapogenin in the form of aglycone. So here, sapogenin, just like other glycosides, the saponins are also hydrolyzed and they give an aglycone known as sapogenin and a sugar moiety. On the basis of sapogenin or aglycones, the saponins are classified into steroid and triterpenoid groups. Both have glycosidic linkage at carbon 3 and have common biological origin. The sugar portion may consist of 1 to 5 sugar units, that is glucuronic acid. So here I have given the structure of steroidal saponin, which is having 4 member ring, 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C and D, and where D is 5 member ring. Here in the case of terpenoidal saponin, it contains 6 rings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A, B, C and D, and all are 6 member. So from a medicinal and pharmaceutical point of view, these saponin class of compounds, they are very, very important. And there are a lot of plants, medicinal plants, they are rich in these saponins, and they are widely used in lot of preparation out of those plants. So I will be discussing one by one their natural sources. First I will take that is steroidal saponins and then terpenoidal. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.